I give for you is y for the increase in the velocity. Initially, we have the area increase, but then after that, the area increase. Right. Usually, when we want to increase the velocity, when we have a hose water, right, you put a nozzle or you squeeze it such that you make the area getting smaller. When the area is smaller, the velocity is higher, and then you get higher. Longer distance.
Right.
That's the what we usually do. Right. But in this case, you find out that when the velocity increase, area is decrease. Why? So if you want to increase the velocity, looking at the mass flow rate is given as rho A V. For incompressible fluid, this one is constant. When this one constant, if you want to increase the velocity, the only way you can do is increasing the area. Right. That is when you have incompressible flow. But then if you have compressible flow, what happened? The rho also changing. It can be decreased, it can be increased, right? That's why you can see after the sonic region, after you reach Mach number equal to 1, you get the area increase, and the velocity is also increasing. Now, if we look at this, we know that with the decreasing in pressure, okay, the velocity starts to increase until it reaches the critical condition here at the throat. Okay, the smaller area in the converging diverging nozzle is called a throat. Okay, so when I say throat, mean it is the lowest area of the converging diverging nozzle, right? Okay, when you have a supersonic flow at the throat, the Mach number is unity, so the Mach number is 1. Okay, when you have a very high velocity, right? After the throat, the velocity keeps increasing even though the area is increasing. Okay, so for this, to evaluate this kind of behavior, we need to. Okay, I know you hate differentiation so much, but no other means to look at it, to analyze it other than this coefficient. Okay? Unfortunately. So you have a conservation mass and conservation of energy. For the conservation of mass, if you take a derivation of it, okay, you take the partial derivation, which means A, V, rho, blah, 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 right? You take partial derivation, you get V rho over rho. Because if you take, it will become divided by rho AB, so this one becomes 0 rho BA A DB B. So this is where it comes from. The partial integration. If you look at the book, that's what you get. So you get this one. Okay? So we keep this one first. Now we move to this conservation of energy. You know this comes from? Where does this thing come from? You remember last week we are talking about this conservation of energy. Q in, Q out, there is no heat transfer, this one gone. W in, W out, there is no suffer coming in or coming out of that nozzle. Right? Nozzle got nothing. And it is adiabatic. So this thing gone. And Z1 and Z2. Okay. So Z1 is, if we look at the nozzle, Z, Z. Usually, this is at the same level. So Z and Z is gone. So you have only H or enthalpy. Remember, H0 is not only H, it is H plus kinetic. Right? Remember, H0 is stagnation enthalpy. It is it comprises of static and kinetic energy. Okay, so if we look at that and you're coming back to the equation, you got H1 plus P1 square over 2. Got it? And H2 plus P2 square over 2. So if you differentiate it, it becomes dH plus P dV. So it becomes dP over rho plus P dV. So this one comes from here. Okay? If you combine this and this, it becomes this. So you get this one, and you combine with this one. You know how to get this one? From here. Move it there. And then rho move there. And then dV move there. Got it? We have dP over rho plus P dV, right? So dP rho minus, remove it, then become rho V minus dP. You replace rho V, dP dP with this, get V. One minus one number one. What is the consequence of this one? Anyone got idea what's the consequence of this? What is the consequence of this? Okay, so if you ask me what is dA, dA is basically the difference between A2 and A1. dP is the difference between V2 and V1. So dA positive means the area getting bigger. dA negative means the area getting dV positive, velocity higher. dV negative, decrease. So if you look at this one, when Mach number is equal to 1, if you want to increase the velocity, what you should do? So negative, huh? So you want velocity increase. If velocity increase, dV is dV dV. When velocity increase, dV positive. This one has to be positive. And Mach number is equal to 1. So this thing becomes 8. Yes.
Sorry, I make a mistake here.
It has to be less than. When Mach number is less than 1, what's this? Positive, right? Positive, positive. dA has to be negative or positive? Okay. Negative, right? dA negative means the area is smaller. Okay, so this thing is the thing that solves your mistake. Now, if you want phi to decrease, when phi decreasing, dV positive or negative?
Negative.
When dV negative and this one positive, become? dA become?
Positive.
When dA positive, it means increase or decrease?
Increase.
Now when my number is more than 1, what will happen? This one become
negative.
Okay? So now if you want to increase the velocity, this one is positive, right? Dv is positive, increasing. So dA has to be positive. When velocity decreases, area need to be decreased. Now the question is, what happens when mass number is 31?